Hello and welcome by AA's Art Channel. My name is Ilkjan Wiersma, and today I'd like to show you how I drew this leopard with my pastel pencils and my pastel sticks and the pen pastels for the background. And I know we officially like to refer to pastels as paintings, but it feels more to me like a drawing because I'm using pencils, sticks and pen pastels. And yeah, I also paint in acrylic and oils, and that's naturally feels more like painting than when I'm using pastel. So therefore I like to choose for the word drawing because it feels more natural for me. And like I said, I know it officially it those if you're using pastels, those are also paintings, but like I said, it feels more like a drawing to me, so therefore I like to refer it as a drawing. And if you missed it, but last week I made a special tutorial on how I make the whiskers. I will have a card pop-up at the end of the video, so if you like to see a bit more how I do whiskers with pastels, and especially on when you build up many layers, so you have many colors on a paper and it can be quite hard to get nice whiskers, I have a special tutorial on that, and like I said, I will have a card pop up at the end of the video. Because first I like to focus on how I did this leopard completely. So let's go over to that tutorial. As you may know, I like to work on the Claire Fountain Pastel matte paper. It is my favorite paper on the moment. I use it basically all the time when I'm working in pastel. It's such a nice paper. It can take many layers, and especially on wildlife, on animals with fur, I like to use as many layers as I can because I like to build up my colors to make it as realistic as I can or as I want. And for this one, I would get quite realistic, and yeah, therefore this paper suits me well, me working in this kinds of projects. And here you see me working with the pen pastels, and you see me using quite some different applicators. And yeah, I'm just building up, because the more pigment on the paper, the more the ability to blend will come with each layer. So therefore I like to build up my layers and making the shapes I see. I have no idea what I'm drawing here or painting here, just depends on how you want to call it, but I like to refer to as drawing, as I said. But yeah, I have no idea, I just making different shapes, and those were in the background, and they have to be there to make it as realistic as I can. And here you see me using the applicator for just giving the suggestion of the direction of the fur. That will make it a little bit easier for me later on. So therefore I'm laying a few lines there with the applicator, so I have it a little bit it will be a little bit easier for me when I'm using the pencils. And maybe you want to notice how many times I switch from different pencils. I'm using different colors, I think at least 10 colors, but maybe 15 colors on such a little section, because I like to blend, and the more colors I use, the easier it will be to blend, and also it will make it much more realistic when you use quite some colors. So don't trust only the color picker of Photoshop, for example. If you use that, just that will give you an indication, but I like to use many more colors. It will give me that richer feel, and especially in fur, the more depth I can create because I'm using quite some colors there. So that's a big tip if you like to use pastels, if you're starting out, of if you already used pastels for quite some time but you cannot make that fur as realistic as you would like. Maybe you should use, or you want to use, a little bit more colors, because it will make it much more and much richer and much more depth. And also I like to mention that some artists are making beautiful artwork, and those like to leave a lot of stripes in their fur, and that's okay, I really like that. But personally I like it more, I will to give it the indication of fur. So I leave some stripes, you can see here quite some lot of stripes of the pencils, but I will blend them a bit later on, because I liked the it gives a more natural feel. It gives more the feel of clumps of fur, and yeah, so I don't want to end up with too many pencil strokes. But I'm using quite some pencil strokes because I
also blend with my pencils. So I hope that makes sense, but the more pencils you layer over each the pencil strokes you lay over each other, the more you will end up blending your strokes. And if you do that quite carefully and you know what you're doing, you can make beautiful fur with beautiful depth. And as I said earlier on, if you're using quite some colors, it will appear, in my opinion, quite nice. And I'm just building up section for section, because I know myself, and I can get lost quite easily on all those fur and all those of the fur, all those hairs, and the different directions and the different length of either each fur, each brush stroke, of pencil stroke, I should say. And therefore, I'm just building up. I'm starting with the black areas, and I'm building up from there, because that's for me the most easiest approach to make the fur. And when I'm making those little teeny tiny hairs, you can see here on his chin, I make sure that I have a really sharp point on my pencil. It's really important. And like I said on the intro in this tutorial, I will have a card pop-up on the end of the video where I will show you how I make those hairs and how I do the whiskers. So if you want to know more about that, I will have a link pop-up on the end of this video. So I talk a little bit more about how I do that. And you can also find the sharpener I like to use and all that kind of stuff. And you see here, this was one of the most nice parts to do for me, is laying on that lighter fur. And I will do that much more in the end of the video, of course, but I have built up my colors. I started with the darkest colors, the midtones, and then just some highlights, and that's when all parts will come together. And it's such a nice moment, because then you know that everything was right what you did. And yeah, that will come with experience. The more you do it, the easier it will go will get. But yeah, that's so nice, because everything will fall into place. And take your time, build up easily, take your time, it's so important. Don't think I know how to make fur, so I don't gonna watch my reference photo anymore, or I think this fur will go a little bit like this direction, it will not be that that off of the rest. But don't do that, don't fool yourself, just keep watching. Even though you think you have it all in your mind, just keep watching, because you don't want to know how many times I was wrong, and how many times I was so glad that I watched my reference photo, because I could correct myself on time. Because I just keep on watching my reference photo. That is really, really important. And you see me do that here again, starting out with the black spots. And also it's easier for me to know where the fur should go, but also I can make some little black lines, because I don't want too sharp edges on the spots of the leopard in his furry black spots, because that will not look as natural as I like. So therefore I make it leave some strokes in the black and overlapping the fur around it. And also I like to use some dark purple and some red on the edges of the black, where the black fur starts, where the lighter fur starts around the black spots, I should say. And those areas I like to use sometimes a little bit of purple and a little bit of darker red, reddish brown purple. And that makes the transition between the both a little bit less sharp. Because otherwise it will look that those spots were not in his fur, but laying on top of the fur, and that will not be as natural as realistic, of course. So therefore I like to use some colors around it, and like I said, most of the times it's purple of a purplish red. Here I turned my paper aside, because it was easier for me to make those to make that longer fur in his neck, and it was a quite fluffy fur. And the fluffy fur I found most of the times the easiest fur to make, because it doesn't matter that much how the length of your pencil strokes do matter, of course, but you can be quite messy. So if you like to start out with fur, maybe you can make some fluffy fur, because that's I think the easiest fur to make. And the hardest can be the curly fur or the shortest fur on his face. I don't have, curly fur, of course, it was a straight and clumps of fur, but the short fur around his nose and under his eyes, that can be quite hard to make. And when I started making that fur around his eyes in the beginning, I thought that it would be a little bit longer than it was. It just are some little dots and dots with the pencils and a little teeny tiny stripes with your pencil, and that's all. Basically, it's more important to use the light and dark colors there, and you will achieve that look of short fur. But once again, the more you practice, the easier it will get. And also the transitions between the lighter fur and the darker fur can be quite hard to make it look more natural. But I like to use different colors there and build up. So I'm trying to work from the darkest area and slightly build up my colors. And I don't use the darkest pencils anymore, but the mid-tones. And from there I'm working towards the lightest colors. And that makes it quite easy to make the lightest hair, and also the transitions between the both. And but don't forget, if you make lighter fur, you also need the darker fur, because otherwise the lighter fur will not show up. And once again, it's just by practice you know how many dark fur and dark layers you need and how many lighter fur. But it sounds harder than it is, I think. Just slowly build it up and take your time. And this is the final piece. I hope you like it. And it's now hanging in my living room. I'm quite happy with it. And I think this is the my personal favorite on the moment in the pastel with the fur. Because, yeah, I just took a much more time to create this. And it will show up in the end. I have a lot more details in it than I usually do this. I should say, because I didn't take the time, but when you take the time, when you watch your transition, the direction of the fur, and use your light and your darks and different colors, you end up with a rich, nice piece with a piece with a lot of depth in the fur.
So, I hope you like this tutorial. Please let me know in the comments below. And also, if you have any questions or suggestions, you can also leave them in the comments below this video. And if you like this tutorial, please give it a thumbs up. I would really like that. And of course, if you like this tutorial and my other tutorials, please subscribe to my channel. And like I said before, I really see it as a compliment for my work. So therefore, please be welcome at my channel. And I have every week a new art video, and I try to make as many art, but sometimes I have a video on tips and tricks. So I like to share with you what I have been learning and what I'm still learning on my way to making art. So therefore, if you like that, please stay tuned on my channel by subscribing. And of course, if you like, you can follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and on my own website. Those links will also be below in this video description. And like I promised earlier on in this video, here is that card that will pop up in the screen somewhere. About a little bit more of more in focus on the whiskers, what how I build those up, which materials I use, and how I do that. So if you like that, check those that part card, and I will explain that to you. So for now, thank you for watching, and I hope to see you at my next video. Bye bye.